Okay, everybody, welcome to First Avenue Playhouse. And tonight's production of The Actress. This is closing night. I'm so happy to see all of you here tonight.
Yay.
It's just wonderful to see a full house here, to see a show, and I hope you come back in our future months. But we have shows booked all the way until December. I hope you come back in our future months to see our other shows. Next month we have Little Women, and I forgot the show that we have after that. Okay.
Sylvia!
I always forget that. So Little Women is next month, and then Sylvia is the month after that. They're both great shows. You've probably seen it. We've had Sylvia here like many years ago. So maybe you've seen it before. Come back and see it again. It's a brand new cast, brand new experience for you. Hope you all come back to see that. Things you need to know, and for the people that have been here before, this is really repetitive, but also needs to be said. In an emergency, there's the exit that you came in. The entrance that you came in is also an exit. There's an exit over here on the right. And if you run all the way to the back, there'll be a door open all the way in the back, and you'll see actors running out the back, and then you run, just follow them right out into the street. And we have the bathrooms over there on the right. There are two bathrooms there, unisex bathrooms. Just not saying two people at the same time, just one in the bathroom. But they'll be there for you for the intermission or any time you want to use them. Pardon me?
You're saying right with your left hand.
I'm saying that because, yes. I'm an actor, so my right is over here on stage, but you're that way, so it's that way. Yes, that's right. Okay, so other things you need to know. We are on Facebook. You can find us always on Facebook, firstavenueplayhouse.org. We are on Twitter. Oh, that's perfect.
That's perfect.
Forget about that. I'm going to go right to the most important thing. Your phones. What happened just now, we do not want to happen during the show. So if you have a phone, and I can't imagine anybody who doesn't have a phone nowadays, please turn your phone off if you can. Turn it off. Turn down the volume. Turn it off. Do whatever you need to do so that we don't hear any kind of noise during the show. Very bad for our actors. You know, these actors learn their lines, they study their lines, they come out here and perform, and all of a sudden, in the middle of one of their lines, a phone goes off. Oh, throws them right off. Oh my God. And I know if you go to Broadway and something like this happens, they actually stop the show. If the actor is out there, they stop the show right there. And they point to wherever that person was. That's kind of funny, too. So we won't do that. But for everybody else, please remember, turn your phones off or turn the sound off so we don't hear them. We don't want to hear any kind of music going off during the show. Okay, so we get back to what it does. We have a book on the bar there where you've got your cakes, where you can sign up. And if you sign up, we will send you an email every month and tell you what show we're doing. We'll also send out emails and tell you if you want to be an actor. We have auditions. We'll tell you that we have auditions. Come to the auditions. Be an actor. You can know the experience that you're watching tonight.
One right
now.
Me too. Okay, fine.
The odd couple.
Show up. I'm not saying that. Show up to the auditions and be an actor. Be an actor and get on that stage. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. So we have Facebook. We have Twitter. We have Google. We have TripAdvisor. TripAdvisor. If you love the show tonight, go on TripAdvisor and tell everybody that you saw a great show tonight. If you did not like the show tonight, skip TripAdvisor. Keep the information to yourself. And give us another chance and come back next month and the month after that. Come back and see us. Okay? Don't judge us on every show.
Everyone's been great.
But every show has been great, right? Every show has been great. What am I leaving out? Oh, money. Wait, what's that? I was going to say money. Money. This is a non-profit organization we have here. If any of you have some extra money you're not using, and I know you all do. We all have money we're not using. Don't save it for a rainy day. Give it to us. Give it to us. We accept all amounts from $1 to $1 million. We have yet to get that $1 million donation. So that's up for your grabs if you'd like to have that. But we need the money. We that's how our theater goes along, that's how we run it, and that's how it goes from month to month to month. So if you have anything you'd like to donate to us, it's tax deductible, please do that if you find it in your heart. And I think I've covered most everything. Smoking, there's no smoking in here. You have to go out on the street to smoke. And there's no picture taking in here. And
Barry, we have dinner packages available.
And Cheryl tells me we have dinner packages available. There's a great dinner package that just came out. It's a new one. A few months ago we just got this. And it's a great dinner package because it's for the town diner, which is right down the street. So you can come and see a show, eat your dinner right down the street, take a little bit of a walk for a couple blocks, and come right here for dessert and see a show. What a deal. $45, I think it is?
Yes.
That's a great deal. So, and we also have another one which goes on a diner on the highway, but this one is so convenient for you. I think you ought to try that if you're interested in doing a dinner package, a dinner and a show package. Come to our theater. Anything else, Cheryl?
You are all done, Ms.
I am all done. All right. So, I'm all done. Now it's time for you to see the show. So here you go. The actress. Thank you.
Business I know, everything about it is appealing, everything that traffic will allow. In the world would you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra pound? There's no people at show, people they smile when they are alone. Yesterday they told you you would not go far, that night you open and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they hung the star. Let's go!
Has someone died?
I know, they've been arriving all day. And I can't even clear them away yet, not until she's seen them. You know how she loves flowers.
And how she hates flowers.
Huh?
Depends entirely on who they're from, don't you think?
I wouldn't know. Last time someone brought me flowers was,
That long, huh?
Yeah. Here, have a seat.
Oh, I can't sit there. That's Mother's chair. She wouldn't like that.
Well, you'll have to clear off the sofa then.
Yeah, I'm just gonna have a cigarette.
Nicole!
What?
You know perfectly well.
Fine, I'll go outside, shall I? With all the other naughty girls.
She needs to protect her throat. Tonight of all nights. Mm-hmm. Where will you be sitting?
At the bar, probably. Just call the stage door when she gets here. They'll find me.
Yes?
Is she in?
Not yet.
Gosh, flowers.
You know, right?
She can open up a shop. Well, we'll go up late. The foyer is full of actors. It's deafening. Trying to get them to quit gossiping and get in their seats could take hours. Even so, I thought she'd be here early. Speaking of actors, Michael says he has a sore throat.
If I survive the night at all, he said, I'm sure by 10 I'll have the flu.
I told him, sweetheart, it's the last ever performance. You can have the Black Death by 10 o'clock and nobody will care. Besides, the supporting cast are just set decorations for tonight. All eyes will be on Lydia, her grand exit. Are we missing anything?
Just the wig. Yes. No, not yet.
Are you planning on stealing something?
What?
Your lipstick, your powder puff, anything? You really should stick something in your purse. I've got my eye on a few little props. Might be worth something in 20 years. By which point, none of us will be worth anything.
Margaret, I really have to get on with setting up here.
Yes, yes, of course. I'll track the wig down for you.
Thank you. Have a good show.
I doubt that. Your phone's ringing.
I know. Thank you.
Is she?
She is.
Hold on tight, it's gonna be a rough night. Actually, I'll check on her a little later. Let her settle in first. Hopefully all these flowers will put her in a good mood. Lavender?
It helps her to relax.
Relax.
I can't talk about it now. You'll have me in tears. Oh, tell Michael it's only nerves. Well, then he should take some sore throat medicine. Of course I don't have any. Oh, no. These flowers can't all be for me.
Yes.
No. So many.
People just wanted to say goodbye.
Oh, don't make me cry. Too many goodbyes tonight.
Oh. Margaret stopped in, no message, and Nicole is having a cigarette.
She came?
She wouldn't miss this for the world.
Oh, yes, she would. Nicole does not like seeing me in a spotlight. She never did. It's very strange. Most people see fame as a gift, not an irritation. But then she always did have an unusual view of the world. Mm. Such flowers. Oh, dear Lord. All these thousands of nights staring at this decaying face before every performance. Well, at least I won't have to do that anymore. I'm having all the mirrors in the new house painted over. It's not a pleasant thing watching yourself age in such detail. Every new crease and streak of gray. And we cover it up with such skill. Oh, we know it's there. By God, we do. Shall we smash the mirror tonight? What? Why not? Throw a chair at it. Watch it fall to the ground in tiny, nasty pieces. Then they'll know I mean it. God, wipe that.
Maybe I should make you an herbal tea.
No, brandy. I need a brandy. And pour one for yourself.
I just did. I'm pouring yours next.
We'll make a toast. But when we're through, hide it. Otherwise, every character who comes through that door will want a glass. And I think I'll need the whole damn bottle tonight. To Catherine, for looking after me.
And to you, for such a memorable experience. Oh. I'll never forget it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's very touching. Thank you. I don't know why I'm so surprised. I suppose we actresses think that all our dresses absolutely hate us behind our backs.
We do.
But you'll miss me when I'm gone.
I will. Oh. Everyone will.
Perhaps. But only for a year or two. And then we'll find some other home for their devotion. I don't mind. Keeping that candle burning is exhausting. Anyway, to Catherine.
No, to Lydia Martin. Her grand farewell. A triumphant final performance.
Triumphant. I'm hoping to live through the night. Down in one.
Ooh. I'll fetch your wig.
Is my daughter outside? Well, tell her to come up. I want to see her. And tell her she should stop smoking. Yes?
It's Margaret.
Not now, Margaret. Nicole is on her way up.
All right. I'll give it about 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Nervous? Excited?
Yes, plus irritated.
I'll check the others first.
The director's asked me to give you a few notes.
Has he?
Perhaps I'll really? Suggest he write them down and slip them under the door. I'm just going to check on the...
Yeah, you do that.
Yeah, I'm checking on that.
Your father.
Better than flushing them down the toilet, I guess.
Oh, yes, that would be a waste.
Can you stop doing that now?
I'm enjoying it. Now you can hug me.
Now I can't be bothered.
Oh, Nicole.
No, it's too late. The moment has passed. It's all about timing. I would think you'd know a little something about timing.
No, you can't be mean to me tonight. I'm retiring.
Until you get bored in Switzerland. Can I smoke?
I will not get bored in Switzerland. It'll be beautiful, romantic, clean. And no, you can't smoke. I thought you gave it up.
We don't give up our addictions in this family.
I am.
That remains to be seen, doesn't it?
Not at all. I'm in love, Nicole. Charles shall give me such a rich, full life. I won't look back. I'll rest. It's what I've always dreamed of. What would you have me do? Die here in my dressing room after a million shows, alone, tired?
Better than dying cold and full of chocolate.
What?
Switzerland, Mother. They have chocolate there. And snow. Didn't anybody tell you?
You're being unpleasant.
Thought it was being factual.
Well, you can go and be factual and unpleasant down in the foyer. There's lots of fascinating people to talk to. It's full of famous actors.
Ooh, actors! Hooray! I'm gonna need a drink.
Well, you can have some brandy, but just a drop. I'll be relying on it this evening.
You thinking of doing the show drunk?
I'm thinking of not doing it at all, so being drunk might be the only solution. Will you visit me in Geneva?
Maybe. I don't know.
Why don't you know? Don't you like snow and chocolate?
It's just... Charles.
What is so wrong with him?
Does it matter? I don't have to like him. He's your choice. I'm the one that's jumping into bed with him.
Why is it always about the bedroom with your generation? You're missing the point. There is so much more to our relationship than sex.
Oh, I should hope so. Men can hardly get up the stairs.
You're being nasty. Why are you being nasty again? Honestly, I don't know where you get it from.
Well, I tell you don't. Good luck.
Don't say that. Good luck is bad luck in the theater. You've been told that.
I forget.
Oh, well, you wish people lots of manure, med, and lots of it. And do you know why?
I don't remember. Or I don't care, one or the other.
The opera house is in Paris. The horse-drawn carriages would bring all the rich people to the theater. And the more carriages, the more horses, the more people in the audience, and therefore, more manure on the road at the end of the evening. So that's why you wish all of the actors lots of manure, mayor.
And I'm sure tonight it will stink for miles.
Oh, thank you. What a sweet thing to say.
You all right? You look a little pale.
Oh, I just haven't finished putting my makeup on yet, that's all.
Is it?
I'm feeling a little fragile. Perhaps I should have just gone quietly, without any announcement, you know, just slipped away when no one was looking.
Come now, Mother. Miss one more moment in the spotlight?
Yes, but tonight it might turn around and bite me.
Too late anyway. Catherine, to you with your head.
Charles is on his way up.
Oh, really?
Oh, come now. He's going to be your stepfather soon, so you be nice to him.
No. He will not be my stepfather. He'll be your husband. I decide who my father is, not some marriage certificate.
Darling. Look, Nicole is here.
Nicole?
Charles? Well, it's been lovely chatting with you. I'm going to go to the foyer now. It's full of actors. I can't wait to get down there and hear all about them. So you two do whatever it is you two do, and I'll see you later.
She doesn't like me.
Oh, of course she likes you. She just takes her own sweet time warming up to people. She ignored me till she was 17. Well, you look very smart.
I came straight from the bank.
Is everything ready for Geneva?
Oh, yes. I will soon have my leading lady all to myself.
Oh, you don't have long to wait. One final show. Have you seen all the flowers?
I have. Are they all from the handsome ex-lovers?
Well, yes, they are, mostly.
I was actually making a joke.
Well, none of that matters now, darling. You've won the prize.
Yes, I just hadn't realized there were so many in the race. No, we have guests. I have to be downstairs. I just came up to wish you a wonderful night and to give you this.
Oh, you don't.
The lady in the shop said it was a theater song.
It's beautiful, thank you. I shall look for you tonight. Where is he sitting?
Dress circle, stage right, boss.
I shall throw you a glance during my big speech in Act Two. You'll be sure to catch it.
No, I will. I won't take my eyes off you. The whole town is yours tonight, and I'm the luckiest man on earth. May I kiss you before I go?
If you absolutely must.
I must, absolutely. I shall count the minutes till I see you again. You make me feel 16 years old.
You are my sweet 16-year-old.
Bon voyage.
Now hold tight to the railing or you'll fall down the stairs.
I'm all right.
Bon voyage.
He isn't a theater person. That's one of the things I like most about him.
When you two actually leave?
Almost immediately. His staff has packed everything away at the house, and we just rest for a few hours, and we take the flight out tomorrow morning. I didn't want to stay and dwell on everything, you know, make a clean exit. Though I'm not sure what all the rush is. Charles does everything slowly. He eats slowly. He walks slowly. But this is all terribly fast. It's very strange. Perhaps he doesn't want to give me a chance to change my mind. I don't know.
Do you want to get dressed now?
No. I don't want the curtain to go up on time. We'll make them wait tonight. We must build a bit of expectation. Mm. I want to walk out on that stage just at the point when they're wondering if I'll turn up at all. It's part of the performance. Being an actress is not just saying your lines.
Not when you're a star.
Well, the public gives you that crown, and they can snatch it away very easily. The trick is to run out the door before they get the chance.
Is that what you're doing?
Perhaps. Or maybe it's just love. I have no idea. We actresses, we rarely know how we really feel or most of the time who we really are. If we did, there'd be no need for us to pretend to be someone else every night, would there? Mm-hmm. We're all just one step away from the madhouse. Has the wig been dressed?
Yes, I just have to set it.
I'm just saying hello. Whatever you do, don't tell me to get out.
Get out!
Lydia.
I said get out. I made it very clear I never wanted to see you again.
Well, that's not very welcoming.
I mean it, Paul. You have no right to be here. For God's sake, it's right before a performance.
I would have been here a bit earlier, but I had to help some old guy get down the stairs.
You must leave. I have no desire to be in your company.
Oh, shut up. You can stop being an actress now. You're retiring.
You don't get to tell me what to... Just go, Paul. Leave.
I most certainly will not. This is my last chance to see you, and I will see you whether you damn well like it or not. And besides, I bought a ticket. Yes, I paid for it out of my own hard-earned cash. Yes, and you are expensive.
Yes, and damn well worth it, every penny. So now you get to spend 2 hours staring at me on the stage, so there is no need to see me now. Mm. Go.
Oh, hello. Are you a friend of Madame?
No, I'm her dresser. I mean, yes. And I'm her dresser.
And you survived? Ooh, congratulations. The streets are littered with Lydia's ex-dressers. She must go through 3 a week. Throw a stone out the window. Chances are you'll hit one of them.
Oh, stop it, stop it. That's not entirely true.
I found her very pleasant to work for.
You're not serious.
You're not very nice.
Oh, I'm delightful. You just have to warm up to me.
Oh, why don't you just leave us in peace and go down to the foyer? I'm sure there are plenty of people down there you can annoy.
I'd much rather cause trouble in here.
Oh, you always were insufferable.
Did you get my flowers? I sent some lovely flowers. They must be in here somewhere.
Oh, yes, I did get them. Yes, yes, yes. And they were lovely. Very thoughtful. Catherine, would you find a vase for these, please? There must be a jumpy old jam jar near the stage door somewhere.
I'll see what I can find.
Don't you get bored with all this theatricality?
Not at all. But I do get very bored with you, so it's not an unfamiliar feeling. How did you even get backstage? They're very strict. There's always dozens of young admirers trying to force their way in, but they rarely get to see me, unless they're hopelessly good-looking or disgustingly wealthy. And you don't qualify.
Nicole passed me through.
Oh, she should know better.
Oh, she knows more than you think. And though she hides it very well, I think our daughter is rather clever.
Yes, well, she gets that from me.
You look beautiful.
Oh, well, of course I know that.
Whoever this gentleman is taking you up to Switzerland, I hope he realizes.
Well, he's not blind, if that's what you mean.
Is he here tonight?
That's no concern of yours, and don't sit down. I've not invited you to sit down.
Now keep your voice down. They can hear you in the balcony.
You have to leave. I'm expecting friends.
What friends?
Important friends. Nice friends. All my ex-lovers.
All of them? Oh, we'll have to move the furniture back.
Jealousy, Paul, from you.
No, I sent you out into the world. I know you get hungry and you'll dine on whatever suits your fancy. We had our time together, and that's that. Now it's memories or a souvenir. Although, I can't quite manage to shake off the feeling that it was enormous fun while it lasted.
Was it? It was so long ago, I can't say I remember.
Oh, but you do, and that's the problem.
Oh, there is no problem, believe me. I am very relieved not to be married to you.
At least I did marry you. No one else has managed that.
Not yet. But there are some lovely churches in Switzerland.
And you can ski all the way down the aisle. I still think our marriage should have worked. Nicole does, too.
Oh, stop it. That's a lie. It was chaos. The whole thing was absurd.
Absurd? Yes. But passionate? Oh, God, so much passion.
Well, that's why it was so chaotic. It was nothing but passion.
Oh, yeah.
It was exhausting. Passion is all very well for a moment or two, but you have to take a break occasionally. Why, I never got any shopping done. How can you believe that you could be behind in your sleep for 7 years?
Yes, it's glorious. Is he rich?
Who?
Is he?
You're on my territory now. I don't have to answer any of your questions. You must leave. I have to change.
Oh, you'll never change. And I hope this Charles knows that. Goodbye, Lydia.
Oh, yes, yes. Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Not even a quick kiss?
No! I know where your lips have been, and I'm not going anywhere near them.
Not even for old time's sake?
Very well. Just for old time's sake.
Absolutely. I promise. Either you turned your head, or my aim is getting very bad.
Well, I don't suppose you've had much chance for target practice, have you? How dare you force yourself on me? I shall call the police.
Oh, yes, the love police. They're never around when you need them.
Oh, I'm glad you find this all so amusing. Our relationship always was a joke to you.
Oh, not true. It always put a smile on my face. We had our happy days, didn't we?
Well, I suppose we had our moments.
We certainly did. And I bet you still think about us every day.
You are so arrogant. Oh, I have had all kinds of lovers, many of whom would have put you to shame.
Oh, I think that's highly unlikely.
Get off!
Oh, would you mind slapping me again on the other side? I wouldn't want to leave here with my face unbalanced. Thank you very much.
I have a performance to do.
Yes, and I have a front row seat to it.
Oh, well, go.
What the hell are you doing?
So I thought I'd leave the director's notes for you. Lydia!
Oh, no.
Oh! Oh, man! Oh!
I can't. This is ridiculous.
Oh, I like ridiculous. Viva ridiculous!
Why the marriage never worked. You have no boundaries.
Oh, the hell with boundaries.
I can't do this. I have a show to do. I have a fiance. I have a fiance and a show to do.
And I still love you.
Oh, no, you don't, Paul. You love the actress, that's all. That's all it ever was. I'm not the actress anymore.
Well, that's the thing. You are, and always will be. Oh, you can run away from theater, but it'll get a map and hunt you down.
Well, that's where you're wrong. I'm finished. Finished with all of it. I want a simple life.
Boring. Dull. You
haven't been here these past 10 years. And yes, it was wonderful. Sometimes. But now... Oh, I don't have to explain. You would never understand.
Well, what the hell are you doing moving to Switzerland? Your heartbeat is here, Lydia.
It's different now. Something has to change.
What kind of change is that? Diving between the sheets with some rich old jerk from Zurich.
Geneva, he's a rich old jerk from Geneva. No, and he's not a jerk. But he's rich. He has more money than I can make treading on that stage for 100 years.
Oh, and you would happily spend those 100 years. Oh, maybe you will enjoy yourself for a while, but come back. You're crazy if you don't come back. This is your entire world.
Yes, it has been, but now...
What?
Now that world is pushing me away. Yes, if I love it. You know how much I love it. And yes, when it's in your grasp, it's still wonderful, but... But the waiting kills me.
Sorry, I don't understand.
No, of course you don't. You're on the outside looking in. You don't see the whole scenario. What you fail to realize is this. They don't write parts for us. Us women. Once we reach a certain age, there are only a handful of roles, and the actress just has to wait for the call. All these younger actresses are rushing from stage to stage. The mature, older actress just has to wait. Oh, I used to run like they did. Yes, go from rehearsal to performance, from interview to concert. Always running, rushing, out of breath. Oh, and it was exhilarating. And then autumn comes. And you find yourself lost, impatient, wondering if perhaps you've now been forgotten and fearing that you actually are. And eventually you get a role. Of course I get a role in Lydia Martin, the great star. That's so clearly fading now because I had to wait for it. Wait for so long that the interval nearly killed me. So however grand the part is when you finally get it, it's not enough. It doesn't wipe the fear away. I'm so tired.
Living by the lake, staring at the view, you think that will be enough?
Well, at least it fulfills its expectations. And I think it will be beautiful. And I'm tired.
The tireless Lydia, finally beaten.
Not beaten, just retreating. Oh dear God, my hair looks like I fell into a hedge.
You never looked better.
Paul, really, it's time to go.
Yeah. All right. Tomorrow night dinner. Delay your trip 24 hours.
No.
With Nicole. Bring Nicole, just the three of us, one last time.
Paul, just say goodbye.
No, I won't. I refuse. They look so much better now that you've displayed them.
Plenty of 10 minutes.
Yes, thank you. Put them there on my table, please.
We do have another visitor, but we should make this the last one. We'll be late going up.
Who is it? Not another lover. I'm tired of lovers.
No. It's your agent.
Oh, for goodness sake.
That's what I said, but she really is dying to see you.
Oh, she always is. Oh, very well, that'll be fine. But just tell her she has to be brief. I haven't even changed into my costume.
Of course. She really doesn't have a lot of time, so please keep her brief if you can.
Of course, of course. There she is! Bravo, bravo!
Oh, how lovely, Harriet. And I see you've come darned with alcohol, even lovelier.
Least I could do. Honestly, I didn't even know what to get you. I mean, flowers are so predictable.
Yes.
Then I thought Swiss chocolate might be funny. But then I thought, no, Harriet, that's not funny at all. So I didn't bring it, because most of my clients aren't funny, including the comedians. And the last thing we need on top of that is an unfunny agent. So here you go, Brandy, instead. Oh, my goodness, I'm a little flustered. Do I even make sense? It's such an emotional night.
Well, I'm trying to do my best not to think about it. Oh, you remember Paul, my ex-husband? He was just leaving.
Well, Paul, what are you up to these days?
Just leaving,
Well, Harriet, would you like a drink? Some of this lovely but inexpensive brandy that you have.
Brandy, very good, of course.
Would you do the honors?
Of course.
Let me help you.
Oh, Jesus.
This is such an extraordinary evening. I mean, I go to lots of important theater events, as you can imagine, but this one is different. I'm so nervous. I mean, some shows are very terrible, of course, and you can't say anything about that to anybody, which is just awful. But I always have to go backstage and earn my 10%. I wish somehow they could drag me away. I need a giant hook or something. But I always go and say all these wonderful things to all these awful actors, regardless of what horrors have just scarred my eyes. Oh, Lydia, after my many years in the business, I now feel if an actor is really bad, we should just tell them so. It could only be helpful information. Otherwise, wife, they're all going to run around for the rest of their lives thinking that they're wonderful, when that's not the truth, and that could be dangerous for all these theater productions. I mean, I don't want to get into a car with someone who thinks they're a good driver. I want a good driver! You know what I mean? Otherwise, we might risk skidding off the road and being burned alive, you know what I mean? Accidents should be avoided, not encouraged. Anyway, cheers!
Cheers! Oh, God, it's nasty. It's horrible. I think I'll have another.
I thought you were leaving.
Oh, yes, yes, I am leaving. All right, just one for the road. That's still bad. Farewell.
At last.
Yes. Perhaps another quick kiss? I'll take that as a no.
He hasn't lost his charm.
No, we should find a surgeon and have it removed.
Well, it's so nice that two of you could stay friends.
We haven't. I have no idea what he thinks he's doing here. Oh, Harriet, it's such a strange night. There were flowers here from all kinds of people. From years ago. People I've loved, hated, admired, and in many cases, deliberately forgotten. I don't like the way it makes me feel. I feel exposed. I should have gone quietly.
No! Never! Make a splash! You always did that so well. Lydia, I don't even know what I'm going to do once you're gone. I mean, you're my only major star. I mean, I do have other clients, of course, but oh, they're all such talentless fools.
Harriet.
It's true. I mean, I don't mean to be insulting. Not all of them are in both categories. Some are talentless, others are just fools. But they do seem to be one or the other. Oh, I'm a terrible agent. I pick all the wrong people. Aside from you, of course. I don't seem to be very well equipped for this part of the business. Maybe I should have become a playwright.
Now you're getting hysterical. Drink some of your brandy.
Forgive me, but you make me very nervous.
Why?
You make everybody nervous. Oh, you knew that, didn't you? I mean, you should be very proud of that, because that's how you can tell that you're a great star and everybody panics in your presence. And you truly are a star, Lydia. Well, for one more night, anyway. And I shall miss you enormously, and I don't even mind telling you. And I'm not just talking about the commission. No, agents do not just care about the commission, is what the rumors. No, we do care for the real talent. We fall a little bit in love with our finest people. I guess when it comes down to it, we're all just frustrated performers ourselves deep inside. Well, not so deep. But we live our dreams through our clients, through you. Oh, you make us part of it, this magic box. And it won't be the same, I'm sorry to say, but oh, I did get a very interesting offer this morning, which, if you were interested, we could discuss over lunch on Monday.
I'll be in Geneva. No more Mondays, Harriet.
Yeah. I thought I'd bring it up, just in case. Oh, Lydia, you can't be persuaded.
No, I've been thinking about this for so many years.
Well, I know you have.
It's all about the timing. I don't want to be one of those old actresses who only appears in public when somebody dies, or only gets to deliver a speech at a funeral. There are too many of us. I want to leave at the top, or at least from a point where I can still see the view. But I shall miss it, all of it. Why, I'll even miss you.
Oh, don't. You make me cry.
Oh, be careful, Harriet. You don't want the other producers to know you have a heart. They'll eat you alive.
Oh, dear. Do you have a tissue?
Oh, yes.
I think I will need one at a certain point. Oh, Lydia. This is a very nice sofa, Lydia.
Yes, I had it brought from home. It's old, but it does the trick.
Is it going to Switzerland with you?
No, I thought I'd leave it for whoever comes along and steps into my shoes and takes over my room, my mirror.
It'll be the sofa for the next rising star.
Oh, yeah.
The next great actress. So the bitch can be comfortable.
Oh.
Now, where was it when you first met me, Harriet? I've forgotten.
Oh, Hedda Gabler.
Oh, yes, I wasn't very good, was I?
Not very good. You were spectacular.
No, I wasn't. Was I?
Yes. You were a marvel. I mean, the whole world opened up to you after that run. I had a fight to represent you. Oh, yes, the whole town was after you, but I got you in the end. For all these wonderful years. Oh, Lydia, you did far more for my career than I could have ever done for yours. I mean, you earned me respect. Oh, there goes Lydia Martin's agent, they would say. And they would nod their heads politely. Before that, I was nobody, really. I mean, just hanging around backstage, just like an old sofa. I have so much to be grateful for. So much to be grateful to you, my
just
lady.
Take the whole box. You think you could save some of those tears for the curtain call? I mean, a bit of open weeping amongst the audience would be terribly effective.
Oh, I shall try.
Oh, good. Now, do you have a cigarette?
Yes.
Yes, well, would you light it and blow it, please?
What?
Well, you know I don't smoke, Harriet. I took years to give it up, and I'm not going back. So if you would just light it and blow in my face.
You won't. What?
Oh, for God's sake, just light the damn cigarette and blow the smoke in my face.
Oh,
I thought that was obvious. Gave it up, Nicole, and I have no intention of going back. That's your generation's problem. You have no willpower. Blow harder!
Anyway, I thought I would stop by again quickly because some annoying man said we had to clear out. He said we were going to be late.
What man?
The one with the clipboard.
Oh, that's the stage manager. His job to make sure the show goes up on time, and it's my job to make sure it doesn't.
Well, anyway, so I'll see you after.
No. Come see me at intermission.
Won't you be busy?
Never too busy for you, my angel. Never, never.
Can you stop doing that now? It's like trying to talk to my mother through fog.
Well, perhaps you would accompany Harriet downstairs before she uses all my tissues.
Yes,
I'll be needing them.
Of course. Well, it's such an emotional night.
Yes.
Right this way, I'll show you the shortcut. Oh, goodbye, my wonderful Lydia.
Yes. I'll leave this cigarette.
All right.
Is Catherine nearby? Well, tell her to come up. And no more visitors. I don't care who they are.
Thank you.
must forgive my saying this, but I don't believe I've ever met such frivolous people before, or anyone who's so unprofessional in business and so generally peculiar. Here I am explaining, in simple and clear language, that you must leave your estate, lease all of the land, without delay. And yet you look at me blankly as though nothing I've said is registered at all.
What on earth am I supposed to say? Tell us, what on earth are we supposed to do?
I tell you each and every day. I say the exact thing, the same thing every single day. Both the cherry orchard and all your land must be leased off at once, immediately. You must go to auction. This is the unavoidable certainty that is staring at you. Tell me you understand. Once you make up your mind, once you decide, finally, we'll have all the money you want in abundance, and you'll be saved from imminent disaster.
But they will lease our land to these horrible common people who rent villas. It's so vulgar. That's what it is, vulgar.
I agree with you. Absolutely vulgar.
Don't you hear me? Must I shout it at the top of my lungs, or should I just burst into tears and fall on the ground in a faint? This is unbearable, such ignorance, such arrogance. I can't stand it. You're too much to bear, you silly old woman.
How dare you? What a thing to say.
You silly, stupid old woman. I give up on you. I abandon you to your fate.
Oh, please, please wait. Please don't go. Perhaps there is some other way.
What's the good of trying to help you?
Please stay a while. It's nicer when you're here. Don't abandon me. I'm terribly frightened. I feel as though this house will at any moment collapse on top of us, crush us all. Have we been too sinful? Is this our punishment? Oh, the sins of my life. Oh, I threw money around without discipline, without consequence, like a woman truly mad with no thought to the consequences. I took as my husband a man who came to my arms, laden with debt. He died of love, a love of champagne in excess. He drank terribly, and I took that sin and made another out of it. And then I fell in love with another man, and I went away with him. And just as it happened, I received the first punishment of my sin, coming like a hammer blow to the head. Here, in this dark river, my boy was drowned. I ran away as far as I could. Oh, running, weeping, never to return here, never to see this dark river again. I shut my eyes and I ran aimlessly, wildly. But he followed me, without pity for me, without respecting my need to be alone. I bought a villa for us, and then his illness began. For 3 years I knew no peace, either by day or by night. The sickness of this man wore me out entirely, dried up my very soul. A year ago, the villa was sold to pay our debts. And no sooner was this done than he abandoned me for another woman. I took poison. What else should I do? What an act so shameful. When I recovered, my thoughts were only of Russia, to return here, to my land. Lord, dear God, have mercy on me. Please forgive me for my sins. I beg you to punish me no more. Is that music I hear?
Yes, it is our celebrated Jewish band. Do you remember?
They still play together? Yeah. Oh, how wonderful it would be if they could come here one evening. to play for us, to calm my soul.
That reminds me, did I tell you I saw a very funny play at the theater last night?
At the theater? Well, I'm certain it was not funny at all. You shall not go and watch these plays. Your time would be better spent taking a good look at yourself, at the grayness of your life. Did you hear it?
It was amazing.
I've never heard applause like it. It's taking the roof off. Oh, look at me, I'm shaking.
Sit down, catch your breath.
Oh, I've never heard applause like it, never. Wonderful, wonderful.
I bet you can't wait to get Bert back out there.
Oh no, I don't want to go back out there. I want to bottle it up right now, this very night, and run away. It's going so well that the only thing we can do is screw it up. Oh, is there tea made?
Yes, but it's still a little hot.
Yes. Oh, well, well, what a night! I suddenly look 10 years younger, glowing like a new bride. Yes. It is a little hot. What's this?
Notes from your director.
Oh, that man is quite ridiculous. Only come in if you're charming. Oh, well, come in anyway.
What a night.
Yes, yes.
Roger is very pleased. He wanted me to let you know that he is very satisfied. And did you get his notes?
Oh, yes. Catch. Did you see them all stand up? I've never seen them anything like that before. It's only the end of the act. Why? It should go down in theater history.
Lydia, just over 10 minutes.
Oh, yes, yes. I must take a nap. It helps me to focus for a few minutes.
For the second half, Roger has a few ideas.
And what does that have to do with me?
The rehearsal's never over. That's what Roger says. We must always keep improving.
Oh, I told you you should have never slept with that man. Now you believe every stupid thing he comes up with.
I happen to agree.
Oh, what is the point, Margaret? In another hour or so, I'll be packing my last bag for Geneva. Improving my craft is no longer of any interest to me. Oh. So, you can just go. Did you hear that applause? Did you?
Yes, I did.
And? And?
Lydia, I
don't...
Oh, and you were wonderful.
Thank you. Honestly, the effort you have to put in to get a compliment around here. Oh, I need a drink. No, not that one, the other one. You know, Margaret, you have a very special talent. You can suck all the energy and joy out of a room in a matter of seconds. Not many people can do that. You should join a circus.
I'm just doing my job.
Your job and Roger's is to support the leading lady.
That's not true. His job is to direct the show whether it supports you or not. And it's not easy. He finds it quite difficult.
That's only because he doesn't know what he's doing. He'd have more success directing traffic. This company of actors knows how to do their jobs. Anton Chekhov has delivered the dialogue. Mary, the costumes, and that strange little man who keeps falling asleep is designed the sets. Roger's contribution is to simply say, how lovely, or getting there, however the mood takes him. That is not directing. That is murmuring useless comments. And if there's anything negative to be said, he hides in the bar while his mistress hands notes around. While he lurks in the shadows. You know, sometimes I actually wonder if he really exists. The 2 months into rehearsal, there was one day when we were halfway through Act One before any of us realized that neither one of you had turned up.
That wasn't our fault. The taxi was late.
So is your careers.
You know, Lydia, I have never been so insulted.
Oh, of course you have. And that's only what people have said to your face. If you heard the rest of it, you'd faint. So take your damn notebook and go bother somebody else. Why don't you go talk to Michael? The audience is very confused because he's all... throat is all croaky and rough tonight. They think he's been possessed by the devil.
When did they add all those extra stairs?
Oh my God,
no, I have to turn right around. If I don't start back now, I'll miss the second half. I wanted to see you. I'm in love with you. Did you forget?
Oh, of course not, you silly, silly, lovely man. Well, do you have time for a drink?
A drink? No, I need to concentrate on breathing. I felt absolutely compelled to come and tell you how absolutely wonderful you were.
Well, you could have telephoned.
Then I wouldn't get a kiss.
Oh, of course,
you're a
lovely man.
Oh, you're a rare gem. I could stay in your arms forever. I'd better go.
Charles.
The second half. I don't want to miss a second. Will they sell the orchard? Won't they? It's gripping.
Oh, Catherine, will you help Charles down the stairs?
We'd best hurry.
Oh, you still have 7 minutes. You'll be fine.
Who's this?
Oh, that's Margaret. She makes occasional appearances on behalf of Roger.
Roger? Who's this Roger? Another one of your ex-lovers?
He's the director. And actresses of my standing never sleep with their directors. It's very unprofessional. And in my experience, no help to your career at all. So, you just go downstairs, wait, and I'll see you there after the show.
So, that was your Charles?
Yes, my soon-to-be husband.
What time are you planning on flying to Geneva tomorrow?
11 a.m.
Might want to make it 10 a.m. He doesn't look like he's going to last that long. Hey, Lydia!
Dead!
How dare you! Give me a towel!
I will not let you use my towel, and still it is a souvenir.
You're absurd! I hope you forget all your lines and bump into furniture and fall into the orchestra pit. Wig first!
Oh, I shall miss the camaraderie of the theater. How long do I have? Well, tell Catherine to come and get me at the last minute. Come in, darling. I can talk, but I must keep my eyes shut.
I just passed Charles on the stairs. You know, it might be faster to just lower him down with a rope.
Don't be rude.
There was also some angry lady that smelled like brandy.
Oh, that was the company manager. They all turned to drink eventually. Sit. Nicole. You should comb your hair, it's tangled.
I was busy today, but I promise I'll comb my hair before I come to Switzerland.
That could be months from now. You won't be able to get it combed through it at all by then.
But you are coming?
Yes, I'll come.
Oh, good. Because I will miss you. Oh, it's lovely there. There's tall trees and rolling hillsides and snow. So much snow. Oh, its whiteness is pure and perfect. Just like I want my life to be. Not like the disaster I've made of it so often.
Don't be silly. You've had a wonderful career.
Oh, and I would give it all up for a normal family life. Yes. Christmas Day. Long walks. Oh, excessive and pointless conversation by the fire. Oh. I'm sorry you didn't have all that. Every child should have a stable home life with a mother and father they could see together in love. Otherwise, how would they know how life should be?
I didn't miss it. I rather liked the chaos. Visiting you 1 week, Dad the next, never knowing where I was going. All those different beds. Not like each one on their toes.
But have you found someone, I mean, to love, to be with?
You don't have to worry about me.
But I do worry. After tomorrow, I won't be here to look after you.
Mother, you have never been here to look after me. When I broke my arm in school, you were off doing an interview. When I failed my exams, you were accepting an award. When I first had my heart broken, you were on tour as Lee Bracknell.
When did you have your heart broken?
When I was 11. Oh. His name was James. He was much older than me. 12, at least. I was so upset, I didn't know what I should do.
Well, comb your hair, for starters. Oh, I'm sorry I wasn't there.
It's all right. I don't think James works in theater now.
Really? Well, get me his full name, I'll have him killed.
Let's not be too dramatic. I did get over it.
Maybe you didn't, deep down in your soul. Maybe that's why you're still on your own.
I am not on my own.
You're not? Tell me more.
No, Mother. It's delicate, and you tend to break things.
Oh.
Lydia, it's time.
Oh, so soon, and still so much to say.
See you later.
She's so nice.
Yes. How on earth did I manage that?
Look at me for a moment. Are you ready? Bring the house down? One last time?
One last time. Thank you. I think you're the only person in this building who likes me. Well, I have a feeling I'm not very nice.
They don't pay you to be nice. They pay you to be an actress. Now take a deep breath. Everyone's waiting for you. You can't disappoint them.
Thank you.
I'll wait sitting here a moment more. It's as though I had never truly noticed what the walls and ceilings of this house were really like. I've never even glanced at them for more than a moment. And yet now, I find myself looking at them so greedily, devouring them, and feeling such tenderness and love.
Yes, I remember. I must have been about 6 years old. And this one Trinity Sunday, I sat before this very window. I can see it so clearly now, watching my father going to church.
Has everything been packed away?
Yes, everything's gone, I think.
And so we will be gone, without even a human soul remaining behind.
Until springtime.
The train, the station.
Come, it's time. We must go.
Yes, until the spring. Until we're all together again.
My sister.
So we look at these walls and windows for a final time. Oh, how my mother would love to walk so gently and silently around this room.
Oh, my sister.
My dead, my sweet, my beautiful orchard. My life, my youth, my happiness. Goodbye. Goodbye.
I've seen it. I know how it ends. They get rid of the orchard. Finally. After 3 hours.
It's your mother's final performance.
Yes, and it's my mother I'm interested in, not the performance. Catherine, it's not important. It's only a damn play.
Keep your voice down. The actors hear you, they'll tear your throat out for saying that. I know a play's not important to us, but to them it's like the whole world will fall apart if they don't get it just right. They really feel it. Never underestimate how much a play means to these people.
You have been working in theater far too long.
Tell me something I don't know. Suppose you want something to drink. The water's still hot. I can make you an herbal tea.
That sounds hideous.
It's good for you.
So what do you do when she's, you know, not here?
Relax, tidy up a bit, eat some of her chocolates and then rearrange them so she doesn't notice.
Can't you go out?
No. What if something happens? A torn dress, a broken ankle, a dislodged wig? I'm on standby like the fire brigade. Actually, I like it here. When everyone else is gone. You know, some people like an empty theater when there's just a single ghost light and rows of empty seats. I like an empty dressing room. The calm before the storm.
Thank you.
Now, don't thank me till you taste it.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
Your mother says it helps her to relax.
So it tastes bad and it doesn't work. So what will you do next week now when my mother goes up to the Alps?
Another show, another actress.
Isn't that easy?
Once you've worked for Lydia Martin, you're a little more in demand. Some other spoiled grand dame will be waiting for me to run her errands and put up with her abuse. Somehow, I love it. I like to care for them and help them do their jobs, and I like that I can save them with a few casual words of encouragement. You know, there have been many times when a show would absolutely not have gone on,
If the dresser hadn't said the right thing at the right moment. We always keep a few compliments here on standby, ready to pull out of the hat when the screaming starts. I don't know. I find that hysteria really invigorating. It's exciting to live on that knife edge. The conflict, the crying, the tears, the anxiety. Who wouldn't want to be a part of that? You don't know what you're missing. It's very entertaining. Better than any play.
I can see why she likes you so much. I think she's really going to miss you.
Do you? Be surprised if she can even remember my name in a year or two. It's shocking how quickly they forget us.
Ladies and gentlemen, friends, this night a little more. One step more. That's better. Well, what can I say? I have no planned speeches. If only Chekhov were here, he could come up with a few lines. Well, dear people, tonight is both ending and beginning. And it makes me reflect on why I chose this profession. A profession that has consumed my entire life for so many decades. What brought me to it at the beginning wasn't the craft, not the words, the costumes. In truth, it just seemed at the time the best way to manage my life. As a child, I could never enter a room with confidence. As a young woman, I can never be relaxed in the company of strangers. You have to know why you want to be an actress. And if your own skin doesn't seem to fit, then playing parts in a world of make-believe is a fine way to find your place, to feel you belong. A journalist once asked me, what I loved most about doing this. And I talked about working with an ensemble. I talked about entertaining the public, about diversity, discovery, creativity. I talked of Chekhov and Shakespeare, Ibsen. But it wasn't the truth. What I love, and I'm almost ashamed to admit it, is the applause. All those say that that's just insecurity, a lack of love and approval you had as a child, a need for some sort of validation. But they haven't actually stood here and heard it. Experienced that intense feeling when it washes over you. Now, to some actors, it's nothing. The last moment of work before the run to the bus. But for me, it's everything. It's my drug. And I shall miss it. Although tonight, somehow, I was no longer that child, still trying to find her place, nor the insecure woman waiting for her applause. Tonight, I found I enjoyed the words of the drama. I found new meaning in them, new challenges in the eyes of the other actors, new ideas.
I think tonight, knowing it was the end, it became purely about the craft, almost for the first time. How unexpected that on a night of such applause, that I was less of myself and more of the actress. That is the parting gift that you have given to me. It was a genuine surprise, gratefully received. Good night, goodbye, and thank you to each and every one of you who have put me in the warmth of the spotlight. I shall miss you and the warmth and everything. Chekhov would have written it better. Damn playwrights, they're always dead just when you need them. Oh, it was so hot up there, I thought I was going to melt.
Here, sit down, I'll get you some water.
Where is the brush?
Do you have the brush? Here, you can take this one.
Oh. Goodness, that was fast.
Is Harriet hello?
Harriet, what did you do? Run all the way here?
Well, I couldn't wait another second to see you.
Well, you're going to have to wait a few minutes longer. I'm not even out of my costume yet.
Well, hurry up then.
Oh, dear God.
You were exquisite, delicious.
She makes me sound like a dessert.
I could eat you up.
There, what did I tell you?
Do you want to put on the pink robe or the purple outfit?
The purple.
Do you need another minute or can I kind of come in now?
No, you have to wait a few minutes. Don't be in such a rush.
I could eat you up. Yum, 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 yum.
Oh, God, I sound like a turkey.
Lydia! 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 Lydia!
Woo! 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 Woo!
Where is a large rifle when you need it?
Now she's a cheerleader.
Yes.
Lonely, I am so lonely. In front of the door here, let me in.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Lydia, you'll drive me to drink if you haven't already. How did you get here so fast?
I am very fast.
Guarantee you are.
Knocked down two stagehands and a teamster.
Faster than the wind!
Oh, dear God.
But at least you look great.
Oh, you're so smug when you lie. All right, let her in. Oh, dear God.
Woo, Lydia!
Yes, 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 please, don't make a fuss. Take a seat.
Night of nights, I could scream!
Oh, please don't bother.
Oh, well.
Oh, Nicole. Oh, you have your mother's timing, clever girl.
So it went well.
Yes, yes. And best of all, you were here.
Ah, so this is where the party is. Lydia, you are a marvel. I couldn't have done it better myself.
Oh, we should have champagne. Do we have
yes.
champagne?
Yes, and lots of it. Nicole, can you help me, please?
Oh, what are you doing with that vase? Woo. Is it full of vodka?
This is my souvenir. A gift from the producers.
Ah.
To thank me for all I've had to put up with.
In other words, you stole it when nobody was looking.
Either way, it's mine.
I must say, Lydia, on stage tonight, you look 20 years younger.
Oh, absolutely. She did. It was miraculous.
I thought the applause would never end.
Ooh, and the speech.
Very interesting, I thought.
Oh, so moving.
Almost real, as if you hadn't been planning it for weeks.
I hadn't. Not at all.
It's very unlike you, but perhaps you are changing.
Well, it's about time.
Well, maybe someone should have a toast.
Yes.
Perhaps me.
Yes.
Gathered friends on an occasion such as this one.
Yes.
Yes.
On such a grand and important occasion.
Yes.
Lydia, dear Lydia, when we, when I, wait a minute. Oh. I got it. We raise our glasses as we toast. Give me just a second.
Maybe you can make the toast later once you rehearse.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I need a good director.
Well, unfortunately, there isn't one around for mine.
Oh, the hell with speeches. Let's just drink the damn stuff. Cheers!
Cheers!
Chair! Quickly.
Oh, Charles! I thought we agreed.
Never mind that.
Oh, my goodness, you're going to hurt yourself.
No, don't worry about me. I'm the picture of health. Anybody got any oxygen? Oh, try the champagne. It's got bubbles in it. Champagne, yes. You were extraordinary tonight. I couldn't wait a minute longer to see you so I could tell you. You took my breath away. Even more than the stairs.
Oh, please, no more compliments. I can't take it. You're all very kind, but no more compliments tonight.
Really? Are we in the right room?
Oh, let me start again. I know now what I would like to say. So,
here you go, my friend. Drink it slow.
Thank you. Now, cheers, everybody.
You are Charles? Geneva Charles?
Yes. Have we met? Not one of your ex-lovers, is it?
Does everyone have another drink? Nicole, top everyone's off, would you please?
Well, Lydia, you did say you wanted a rest. I think now we can safely guarantee that.
Shut up and sit on the sofa.
Yes,
no,
ma'am.
No, thank you. I got a visit with the other cast members before they leave. Goodbye, Lydia.
Thank you.
May the Swiss air cleanse you. And now, for my grand exit.
She's a bit odd. She's the one courting the director, isn't she? I've not met the director yet.
Neither have we. Except for an odd murmur. He's an extremely strange man. But then all directors are. They should be put on display in a museum. People would find them fascinating.
Oh, Lydia! I know now what I would like to say. Can
but
I...
the question is, Harriet, does anyone want to listen?
Oh, well, that's
chocolate.
A bit.
Other chocolate.
I think Catherine ate them all.
I did not. They're right here.
I'll miss people bringing me chocolates.
We do have chocolates in Switzerland, you know.
Oh, yes, of course you do.
I shall buy you some every morning. While you're still asleep, I'll get up and walk to the shops.
Oh.
I hope the shops aren't up a hill. You won't see them all day.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Nothing. I was just... Lydia, I would really like to hear more about Switzerland. Tell me about it.
Oh, you don't have the slightest interest.
No, I do. I do, really. If you're going to leave all of this for that place, I'd like to know what's so special about it. Is it beautiful?
It's beyond beautiful. Oh, you look across the lake and you see the Alps, iced in white, in a perfect reflection in the cool water. And overhead the birds fly, while the occasional boat drifts past the edge of the lake, and the wooden jetties, and the charming small villages. Oh. And in the spring, there are all these small, colorful flowers everywhere you look. Oh, on a crisp breeze.
That's right. Exactly right.
Oh, and there's so much to see. Oh, you get to visit different places. French, Italian, German, each with their own restaurant. Why, you could have a croissant, pizza, and sausage, each in its own language, all in one afternoon.
Won't you get very fat?
Oh, I do hope so. Oh, the food is exceptional. The people feel light. The streets clean. It's what I've always dreamed of. And now it's mine. And best of all, I get to share it all with Charles.
So what are you going to do all day with Charles, apart from me?
Oh, well, we never run out of things to do, right, darling?
We talk for hours. Wonderful conversations.
Yes, oh, we never run out of things to say. Although, sometimes I just sit quietly and listen intently. Charles is a fascinating, miraculous man, and the love of my life.
So, you finally got everything you wanted, huh?
I did.
Yeah, good. Yeah. Good for you.
Yeah, good for you!
The trunks are here for the costumes. The costumes, the trucks, let's move, people. Come on. Out with the old, in with the new. Carter, can you grab the wig, please? I could. I might see if I could take it home with me. Put it on display at the end of the hall. On top of a spike. Spike.
I'm beginning not to like her.
Perhaps we should start packing up all the rest of this stuff. Doesn't it all have to be out tonight?
No, I'm not ready for that. Not yet.
Why not?
Oh, Nicole, closing night is always a very strange affair, even in the most insubstantial of rooms. Didn't you notice all that activity out in the corridor? All the party, the great buzz of excitement. Smiles and tears and the chaotic exchange of phone numbers. And then, as each actor takes his leave, with laughter still ringing in the air and a cheery wave, and then it all stops. And as you watch each of them walk down the street, they look terribly alone. That's the thing about it, you see. After all the company and chatter, after all the applause and elation, we walk home alone. That's what actors are. That's why all actors drink so heavily, delaying that walk as long as they can. That's who actors are. Happiest, saddest people on earth.
But you're not sad tonight. You're walking home with me.
Yes, and on the eve of a big adventure. So, you're right. Let's make a start. Nicole, would you help me clear the cards, please? All It's a recollection, a card. Each one has a recollection of some old show or other. This profession leaves you with a lot of potent memories.
You're very lucky to have found something you love to do. That gives you so much to look back on.
Yes, I am lucky. And I know it. You'll be lucky, too.
I'm not so sure about that. I have a feeling I'm never going to figure out what I want to do with my life.
Nicole?
I mean, I'll fill it up one way or another, but I just still have no idea where I'm going.
Don't be silly.
Well, it's not silly. Hardly anyone among my friends has any plan, any path. I'm just a lost generation, drifting along. But then I see you, how you knew what you wanted to do from such a young age. I'm really jealous of that. You've never been lost, have you?
Finding your career doesn't always bring you happiness.
No, but you know who you are.
And we'll know who you are, Nicole. It just takes time. And I have plenty of that now, so I can help you. You can come and stay with us as long as you like.
I like it here.
But I won't be here, darling, silly. Now let's get a start on these flowers. They have to all be taken down to the stage door. We'll each take a handful each, and no, not you, Charles, obviously. Harriet can take extra.
No, Harriet can't.
What's the matter with you?
I had a speech.
Have you drunk all my brandy? Oh, why didn't you drink the one you brought? This is expensive. Oh, for goodness sake, it's more than half gone. I thought you only took 10% of everything. Oh, anyway, let's get rid of these damn flowers. Yes, you take the bunches, Paul. Nicole, can you take these big bouquets? All right. Oh, my God. Oh, it's suffocating here. I can't breathe with all these damn flowers.
No one can leave yet. We haven't had a toast.
Well, we won't be making a toast. We're cleaning the flowers away.
Save me one for my buttonhole.
Oh, well, you can have a forest full for your buttonhole, darling. In fact, why don't we take these single roses and press them into our books?
Books? You read now? When did this madness start?
I would like to...
I never used to read my books anyway. Always scripts and more scripts. Oh, but books are so wonderful. You get lost in them completely. Why, Charles has bought me a complete set of some, haven't you, Charles?
Can I finally speak?
Oh, will you shut up, Harriet?
No, you shut up, damn you, to hell!
I will not have you shouting in my dressing room.
It's not your dressing room anymore. Beatrice Lovechild is going to star here on Tuesday in Cleopatra. Should she's in, you're out.
I do not appreciate your tone.
You don't appreciate anything or anybody. You never have. Making us all run around after you like bloody puppies. And your constant whining and complaining and nothing is ever good enough. Ever. And all we ever do is give you the best of everything. The best theaters, the best plays, the best salaries. And nothing is ever enough, ever. I mean, there are actresses, thousands of them, who would weep with joy at the prospect of just one night standing in your shoes. And you spit on each and every one of them.
I don't think you have any right to...
Have you thought about, for one second, what will happen when you leave through that door? The people who will get trampled under your feet? Did you ever ask me if I wanted to retire? Did you? Well, I don't. I don't want to retire. I want a life. I want more of my life here. I want... people to still see me. I want gentlemen to tip their hats. I want to be respected. I want to be part of it. And you care nothing for it. You care nothing for what will happen to me.
think you had better leave.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Throw me out on the street. All right.
Am I the only one who enjoyed that?
Well, I...
Just forget it. She's been drinking all night.
Is it my fault that her actor's list is like an actor's graveyard? Why is that my fault? Just because she doesn't have any experience, her client list is like horrible... Why, she should be grateful she's had me all these years. I didn't even want an agent.
Lydia, calm down.
I didn't! What is the good of them anyway? What is their point? What is their purpose?
To keep you in control, I expect.
You don't know a thing about it, Paul, so just stay out of it. Oh, God. It's these flowers, I can't breathe. Oh, God. Just get them out of here. Just take them out. Oh, my God, I can retire whenever I want. I can go where I want, do what I want, when I want, can't I? Oh, for God's sake, that's not a rhetorical question, can I?
Yes, sure.
Oh, just take those flowers away before I catch Hay Fever.
If you're not still with us by the time I get back, it's nice to meet you.
Oh. Where the hell are you going?
I'm not accustomed to all this noise. I need some air. Wait for you down by the exit.
Oh, so that's the way it's going to be, is it? Anytime something unpleasant happens, you just run away as fast as you can?
I wish I could run away.
I need someone to support me. Someone I can lean on. Can I lean on you, Charles? Can I? Or will you just topple over?
We'll discuss this when you decide to be a little more civil.
Civil?
Civil, yes. Do you even know what that means?
Yes, I do, you Swiss fool.
Fine, the Swiss fool is leaving.
Good. Just go, will you? Jump into it.
What was all that noise?
Oh, it was my agent's career coming to an end. It was deafening.
You cleared the flowers. Should I...
Yes. Take the final bunches and... help Charles down the stairway or push him down or whichever takes your fancy. I could care less at the moment.
The best thing we can do is as quickly as possible get you out of this building. Theaters are clearly not good for your state of mind. From what I can see, you're all half crazy.
Only half?
There are very few actors in Switzerland. That's why it's so quiet.
You all right?
No, I don't think I am. It's suddenly so empty.
Well, to be fair, it's a little less empty now. I'm standing here. Have you been crying?
No. Maybe a drop or two. It's funny, I thought I'd emptied that supply during the show. I guess the real tears coming from a different part of you. Oh,
girl is so frightened.
You?
No. You're not frightened of anything.
I didn't used to be, but I'm getting older.
Don't be ridiculous. Actresses don't get older. They get better wigs and more makeup.
That's true. Until the day arrives when they can't learn their lines. And then they age so quickly that it knocks them right off their feet. Are you just going to stand there? Are you holding the wall up?
Well, that might be necessary. Word has it that when you leave the building, the roof will cave in. This building will die without you.
Oh, that would be so nice if it were true, but the next wagon full of young performers is already rolling into town.
Do you need a hug? I'm fully available for hugs or something
Don't
a bit more.
Don't make me slap you again. It's very hard on the palms.
All right, then. I'll just stay over here. My dentist will appreciate it, and I can look at you from a distance.
There's no law against that.
There should be. You have no idea what I'm thinking. Lydia, why did you ever leave me?
Oh, Paul, not now.
It makes no sense. I'm gorgeous.
No, you're not. You're arrogant and short-sighted. That's not quite the same thing.
I still think if you and I had only given it more of a chance.
More of a chance? For God's sake, Paul, you had a dozen of bears.
A dozen? Oh, you exaggerate. It was no more than 10.
Ha!
And you had already left me at that point.
We were still married.
Only technically. The house was for sale. You had removed all your possessions. And you told me you never wanted to see me again.
And how did that work? You followed me around the entire country during the tour of Hamlet. I couldn't get rid of you.
I wanted to patch things up.
Oh, and how did you go about that? By having sex with the actress playing Ophelia. Oh, I was so humiliated. Oh, the poor thing didn't know what hit her.
Oh, I wouldn't put it quite like that.
Oh, and you had affairs with all the other females in the play, including the blonde who was the lady's maid, or if rumor has it true, both the lady's maids. By the end of the run, you slept with every woman in Denmark.
With you rejecting me on a nightly basis, what was I supposed to do? I still loved you. And before Hamlet, I never even looked at another woman. I didn't. I was there for you.
Well, if you were, I didn't see you.
Then maybe you should have looked up from your script occasionally. It's not easy competing for your attention with 1,000 cheering people. Being in theater is all well and good. But if that's all you think about and all you talk about, then how much room is there left for a genuine human relationship? Damn it, Lydia! If you can walk away from it all for some rich old banker, why couldn't you walk away from it for me?
I don't know.
Well, that's not an answer.
Well, it's all I have. How can I be expected to remember how I fell over a decade ago? I can barely remember how I was feeling yesterday. It just didn't work. That's my pathetic answer. I'm sorry. However, I do, on occasion, regret it somewhat. And I'm pretty sure Ophelia regrets it too.
I find that hard to believe. Whatever happened to her, by the way?
Well, she didn't go running off to a nunnery, if that's what you were hoping. You're not that good. No, I think she got a part in Charlie's End. But we don't have to talk about her, do we?
No. Let's talk about you. And me.
Oh, God. You're exhausting.
So they tell me.
Isn't this room terrible? They're the most awful places once they start clearing things away. All of a sudden, it's like you're at a funeral.
Hey, let's go for a walk.
A walk?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'd like a final wander around the stage. Oh, you'll really like it after the show's over. It has a very special atmosphere.
haunted, but friendly. Catherine, are there any lights left on stage?
Just a ghost light, that's all.
Perfect. We're all ghosts like us.
Charles is waiting downstairs.
I know. We're just going to have a few final moments before. Could you just clear the rest of those things and just throw them all into the makeup case?
Sure, I'll make sure that Charles gets that along with your coat.
Thank you. You're an angel. I'm going to miss you.
Will you?
Chocolate.
Oh, I'll pass. Who bought you those?
Oh, I don't know. Some water.
Which one? Don't you like anybody you've been to bed with?
Well, I like them when I went to bed with them. But then at some point, they feel they have to tell me all about themselves, and it's generally downhill from there.
You always had terrible taste in boyfriends.
Yeah.
And good taste in husbands.
Well, you would say that.
And I just did say that.
Oh, no, Paul, that's not why we're here.
Well, I just thought perhaps, well, you know, we did rather enjoy our little tumble in the bushes, didn't we?
That was a silliness that will not happen again. It was before the show, and I was very nervous. Scared. I don't know what I was, but I wasn't myself.
Oh, it was you all right. I saw you in there. And it's not a bad way to say hello or goodbye. Can I ask about Charles? How old is he exactly?
Doesn't matter. Age is only a number. There's no law that says you have to act your age. It's no more sensible than acting the number of your house. Whatever his number is, Charles is, he has the mind of a vigorous 40-year-old and the sexual libido of a teenage boy.
Hi, teenage boy. You mean no idea what he's doing, but lots of enthusiasm?
You'll never get to spend enough time with him to realize what a wonderful man he is, but it's something that I know for sure.
Nothing's for sure nowadays. Lydia, are you really going?
Oh, you're so ridiculous, Paul. Can't you ever just accept things as they are?
It's just that I thought in the show tonight, that speech you gave at the end, I thought I saw something, a flicker of doubt.
Oh, you were mistaken. And just to prove the point, in a year's time, you can come visit us. Mm-hmm. See how settled we are, how happy we are.
How cold you are.
You don't notice the cold because it's so charming there. So different. So clean.
I'm always a little worried when the foremost adjective used to describe some place is clean. Who wants to live somewhere because it's clean? I would think it's the last thing you should care about. If there aren't a few bottles in the street, one or two rats, and maybe a little blood or urine, then how exciting can the place be? I don't want to live somewhere that's sanitary. I want to live somewhere that's sexy. Maybe even a little dangerous, because that's when you know you're alive. Lydia, You can change your mind.
No.
Yes, you can. And you should. If you're not absolutely certain about where you're going, then stay where you are. I read that on a poster somewhere, but it doesn't mean it's not true.
I need a script. That's my problem. To tell me what to do. But one thing I am certain of is that I am had enough of this absurd theatrical life.
And without it, who are you?
So if you know me so well, tell me how it ends. Mm-hmm.
That's for you to decide.
But I don't know. I don't know how it ends.
Lydia, I'm waiting. Are you coming? Lydia? Lydia, are you coming? I've been waiting. Lydia? Lydia, are you coming?
Yes, Charles.
Lydia, you'll be back. You have to come back.
Maybe. One day. Do you think the audience will wait for me?
I have no idea, but I will.
Thank you.